bring to our pain. Amen.
Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah. Let us continue in that spirit of awe. Manatili tayo in awe of who God is. Kagaya ng mga declaration natin that our God is great, our God is loving. In our brokenness, He chose us. Pinili tayo ng Panginoon. And today, God, Lord, we thank You, Lord, for choosing us, Lord, kahit hindi kami karapat-dapat, Panginoon. Pinili mo kami, Panginoon, and as such, Panginoon, Lord, nagpapasalamat kami. And sa hapon na to, Panginoon, patuloy na ipaalala mo sa amin, what is the purpose? Bakit nga ba, Panginoon? Para saan nga ba, Panginoon, ang aming mga buhay? Para saan nga ba, Panginoon, ang aming pagsamba? Para saan nga ba, Panginoon, ang aming iglesia? Patuloy na mangusap ka, Panginoon, mightily in us and through us sa pamamagitan po ng iyong mga salita sa kapangyarihan ng banal na Espiritu. Ito po ang aming dalangin sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen. Amen. Papuri po sa Panginoon. Manatili po tayo nakatayo and let us read our one verse text. Today, can I have my Bible, bro? Yan. Isang verse lang tayo today. So, hindi kayo masyadong mahirapan. Okay? Yun po, sabay-sabay po natin basahin. Our verse for today is taken from Acts 1 verse 8. So, sabay-sabay po tayo. 1, 2, 3. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, and in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. Pakaupo na po tayo. Ayan, magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Ayan, sa mga nagtataka po, yes, taga Bahrain pa po ako. So, yung iba nagtatanong, taga dito ka pala ngayon. Taga dito po ako nagtatrabaho. You don't see me often, pero may CPR pa din po ako. Okay? So, salamat po sa Panginoon for another chance to speak po sa pamamagitan ng pulpitong ito na ipahayag po ang salita ng Panginoon. This month po, month of February, we will be entering a series on missions. And we entitled it, Missions is Everything. And everything as missions. So gusto po namin ipakita sa inyo, ano ba yung context nito? Why are we saying that missions is everything and that everything is missions? For us to understand, we have to go back, what is missions? Tatanong nyo na pabuhi sa sarili nyo. Inisip nyo, what is mission? Ay, yung ginagawa ni Pastor Eri. Mission yan. Okay, so balikan po natin sa scripture, ano nga ba yung sinasabi? Ano nga ba yung missions? Sabi po, what is Christian mission? Kasi maraming mission eh. Okay, ang Red Cross may mission, ang maraming may mission. So we're talking about the Christian missions. Sabi po dito, following Christ's call, sharing the gospel with the lost world through God's wisdom and strength. That is missions. Okay, ang missions daw po is we follow the call of Christ to share the gospel with the lost world with through God's wisdom and strength. Ano pa? It is the holy collision of the mission of God and the nature of man. Ibig sabihin, ito daw po yung may mission daw ang Panginoon. Titingnan natin yan later. And then, nag-collide yun with our very nature as the redeemed people of God. That is missions. Pag nagsama yung mission ng Panginoon at yung kakayahan nating mga tao, that is missions. Okay. It occurs when the redeemed mankind become the agent of God's mission. Yun po ang mission. It's an overarching truth in the scripture. Makikita po natin, ito po ay isang katotohanan from Genesis to Revelation. Makikita po natin siya doon. So ano po yung difference ng missions and church planting? This is what we want to emphasize today also. Kami po, we call us missions team, but actually we are a church planting team. Yun talaga yung purpose ng team namin. We are to plant churches as the Lord will allow us. So ano yung missions? What is the difference of missions and church planting? Church planting is part of the missions, but it's not the full missions per se. Ibig sabihin po, yung pong church planting ay parte lang ng isang mas malaking kahon na bumubuo sa missions. Okay, so today we will not be talking about church planting, but we will be talking about the missions. Okay? Tapos po ito po, I wanted to pray for us. Because this year we want to relaunch the missions ministry, quote unquote, into church planting ministry, and we want to ask your help. We want a name. So isa pong naiisip namin na name para tumatak yun sa atin is Beyond Borders ministries. Kasi po, di ba, we go beyond Bahrain, we go beyond the UAE, we go beyond Bohol, we go beyond Pasig. So, beyond borders ministries. Kung may naisip po kayong pangalan, let us know and we will be praying about it. And another thing, this year, ilo-launch din po natin ang BCF Campus Ministry with an initial working name of Sandbox Campus Ministry. Bakit Sandbox? Kasi yung Sandbox daw, deserto eh, Bahrain. So, very Bahrain pa rin, di ba? May sand. Pero Sandbox kasi, if you're planning something big, you train it on a sandbox. Makikita niyo po yan. A sandbox is actually a development area. It's a place where you develop things that you see something great coming out from it. And we believe that our young people, sila po ang pag-asa ng ating bayan. Sila rin ang pag-asa ng ating iglesia. Kaya po, ang tawag po natin sa campus ministry, working name pa lang po ito, nating official. You can also send us your suggestion. We will call it the Sandbox BCF Campus Ministry. Kaya po, so isama nyo po yun sa mga panalangin ninyo as we are working on it this year. Ayan. So, tingnan po natin, ano po yung theology ng missions? Ano nga ba yung basihan natin for the theology of mission? It started with God. Sabi, the redemptive activity of God recorded in the Bible sets the pattern for missions. God sent His only Son, sino yun? Jesus, to seek and save the lost. So si Lord, si God ang initiator nito. Siya talaga yung, siyang pasimuno ng missions. And then, He's using the Word of God. What is the role of the Word of God in missions? The revelation of the missionary nature of God and the missionary nature of the church to all people is the central theme of the Bible. The central theme of the Bible is Jesus and His redemption story. Okay, yun po yun eh. Na, kaya po ang sinasabi natin, missions is the central theme of the Bible. Okay, next. The church. Okay, ito lang po yung ginamit natin. Ano daw po? The relation between the kingdom of God and the universal church and the local church. Okay, ito po actually yung focus natin today. Ano po yung relationship ng kingdom of God with the local church and the universal church? And last, and one more, the people. Okay? Equipping of the saints for the work of the ministry. Ito naman po ibibigay sa atin next week ng ating Pastor Mandy. That is the part 2 po nitong series na to. Okay? And then lastly, of course, this is all in the working of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit that reveals it to us. The Holy Spirit that appointed us. The Holy Spirit that empowers us, encourages us. It's the Holy Spirit ang nagpapaalam sa atin, this is who you are. So, ano po, sabi rin, I am a missionary. At least may 10 convinced, no? Sige, balikan natin ulit, okay? Ang sinasabi po natin dito, missions is everything because you are a missionary. And everything that you do leads towards that fulfilling that mission of God of redeeming, to seek and save the lost. So, ibig sabihin po, next time, pag nakita niyo po ako, hindi lang po ako ang missionary ng church. Hindi lang po yung mga kasama kong nagmi-mission ang missionary ng church. You are a missionary. Pakisabi nga po sa katabi niyo, you are a missionary. Okay? Kasi po, lahat tayo representative ng Lord in fulfilling His redemption plan. Okay? So, panoorin po natin ito. Ay, wait lang. Wala pa pala. Sorry. Missions is systematic theology in action. Okay? If you know Jesus, if you know your Father, if you know the Holy Spirit, if you know the Bible, if you know heaven, hell, if you know the church, if you know all this, it leads you to one thing, becoming a missionary. Because missions is systematic theology in action. Diba? Lahat ng alam natin will lead us to one point. And that is to be a missionary for Christ. Yun po. Ito na talaga.
Lately, it seems that we're getting more and more confused about what a church actually is. So let's take some time to set the record straight. Church is not a building, though a building can be used by a church. Church is not a denomination, though a set of beliefs should be important to a church. Church is not about Sunday, though a church should not forsake meeting together. Church is not about one person or personality, though every church should be pastored. And church is not about size or growth, though every church is called to make disciples. So don't think of church as an address or a location, but rather think of church as mobile and on the move. Don't think of church as something built or planted, but rather think of church as something deployed. Don't think of church as where you are for an hour each week, but rather what you are every day of the week, because the church is the hands and feet of Jesus Christ. Feet shouldn't sit still. Hands shouldn't be idle. Feet go. Hands do. This is the church. Church isn't what you're sitting through right now, because you are the church. Now go and be the church.
Okay, so for today po, we will be focusing more on us being the church. That's why our sermon for today is entitled, The Church on the Move. Ayan, you can use the hashtag Church on the Move. Okay, so let's go back to our verse. Sabi po dito, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. We will be focusing on these three words or group of words. So first one is power. Pakisabi nga po, power.
Power.
Open-minded ba kayo? We usually hear that word, you know, power. Pero ano nga ba tong power na pinag-uusapan natin or pag-uusapan natin this afternoon? It's about a new and miraculous power enabling the recipient to persist despite persecution and suffering. Sabi po ng scripture, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. Makakatanggap ka daw ng power. Ano yung power na yun? Natanong nyo na ba sarili nyo? Ano nga ba yung power na yun? What is that power na that Acts 1:8 is talking about? So ngayon po, bibigay po ako ng at least 3 points that I think yun po yung power na ibinibigay po ng Holy Spirit sa atin. First is a full conviction of who Jesus is and His commands. Okay? Sabi po dyan sa 1 Thessalonians 1:5, binigay sa atin ang gospel at kalakip nito yung full conviction. Sure na sure ka that Jesus is Lord and Jesus is my Savior. You know what? The problem with us witnessing is not about, not that we cannot do it. Di ba? Most of the time daw, alibay lang natin yun. Pastor, hindi ko kaya. Pastor, nahiya ako. Pastor, ganito. Most of the time, the problem with us not witnessing is because we're not sure of who Jesus is. Because if we are sure of who Jesus is, the early church died of that assurance na kilala nila kung sino ang Kristo nila. Di ba? Kasi kung kilala mo kung sino ang Kristo mo, you will run out of reasons not to talk about Him. Kasi you know kung ano yung nagawa niya eh. He defeated death. He defeated sin. He was resurrected at the third day, and He's seated at the right hand of God. Then what is there for you to be an alibi not to talk about this Christ? Okay? So ang una daw pong ibinibigay sa atin ng Holy Spirit is yung power of having full conviction of who Jesus is and His commands. Full conviction. 100% sure ako. 100% sure ako. So pag hindi ka sure, ask for that power. Lord, parang may doubt ako. Lord, give me that power to be sure of my conviction, to be sure of who Jesus is in my life. And His commandments. Ah, baka para lang sa kanila yung command, hindi yan para sa akin siguro. Ah, itong command na to, alam mo yun yung namimili ka lang kung ano yung pwede sa'yo at yung pwede sa iba. That's not what conviction is about. Conviction is not what you think. Conviction is what God says about you and what you should be doing. Dapat alam mo yun. Dapat sure ka na tinawag ako para magsalita, para i-represent si Christ. Dapat sure ka doon. Okay? Hindi ka na nga sure sa Christ mo, hindi ka pa rin sure na dapat i-represent mo siya. Then what we will do? We ask for the power of the Holy Spirit to be with us. Next. The courage despite suffering and boldness. Sabi mo dyan sa 2 Timothy, He did not give us the spirit of timidity and fear, but of boldness, of persistence, na kahit ano pang suffering, kahit ano pang persecution, magpapatuloy ako. Ano po, di ba? The early church died for this cause so that the gospel will reach us today. Dapat ganun din yung conviction mo. That is the power of the Holy Spirit working in you. That you know, I will be persecuted. Hindi naman pwedeng madali eh. Di ba? Because Jesus himself, di ba, na-persecute siya. Dumaan siya sa lahat ng paghihirap na to. Bakit mo naisip na exempted ka? Di ba? Kapag naisip mo na, Pastor, mahirap eh. Then that's the time you should go. Because that's the time you will see the power of the Holy Spirit working in you. Kapag mahirap, ang saya. Diba? Pag mahirap, Lord, ang hirap nito, mukhang hindi to tatanggap sa'yo. But use me by the power of the Holy Spirit. I will share the gospel to this person. Hindi yung, Pastor, baka hindi pa siya ready. Diba? Minsan nagpanggap ka ding Holy Spirit eh. Hinusgahan mo yung tao kung ready siya or hindi eh. Diba? And sometimes we talk to ourselves as if we know what the Holy Spirit knows. But in fact, the Holy Spirit knows who's ready and who's not ready. Your role is to speak and to witness about who your Jesus is. Okay? So let's not look for limitations. Let's not be afraid of persecution. Let's not be afraid of suffering. Sabi diyan, share in my suffering. Makibahagi kayo sa suffering ko in sharing the good news. Yeah? So, ibig sabihin po, when we share the gospel, may suffering talaga. So, ano ibig sabihin? May konting bawas sa tulog, may konting bawas sa comfort, may konting bawas sa bulsa, may konting bawas sa oras, may konting bawas sa mga quality time mo, sa sarili mo, or sa mga ibang tao, mababawasan talaga. Sometimes, hindi nga konti. Sometimes, full talaga yung kailangang ibawas. But that is part of the mission. That is part of what you are called for. Pag hindi ka na nagsasuffer at hindi ka na napapersecute, magtaka ka. Malamang natutulog ka na. Malamang natutulog ka na sa pansitan. Malamang natutulog ka na and you're not fulfilling your mission. Okay? Pag nakakaramdam ka na, parang Lord, medyo komportable na ako ah. Matakot ka. Okay? Pag medyo komportable na ang pakiramdam mo, nakakatakot yon. Because you're not serving your purpose. You're not serving your mission. Next, you become an effective witness. In Acts 11:24, sabi doon, Barnabas was a good man. He was filled with the Spirit and many came to Christ because of his testimony. Ano po yun? Diba? Yun lang eh. Yung power of the Holy Spirit working in your life, yung i-reflect niya yung buhay mo, how good and great your God is, that can turn people into Christ. Diba? Sometimes we add things eh, Pastor, papakainin ko sa magandang restaurant. Those things are good. Masarap. Pakainin nyo rin ako minsan. Alam nyo, masarap yun. Those things are good. But that is not where the power lies. Hindi naglalayo yung power ng witness mo sa mga bagay na kaya mong gawin or kaya mong ibigay. The power in your witness lies with the Holy Spirit and your dependence on Him. Yun yun eh. Yung power ng Holy Spirit that you allow Him to work in you, that is where the power is. Okay, sometimes we think too much eh. We think of so many things, so many strategies, so many programs to reach people. Not realizing that His good deeds and being filled with the Holy Spirit resulted to people seeing Christ in Him. It's not programs. It's not strategies. It is a Spirit-filled life that brings power. Okay? Yun po eh, kailangan ng daan, I should be Spirit-filled. Patuloy akong magpapuno, patuloy akong magpaapaw sa Espiritu ng Panginoon. Kaya napakahalaga po nung daily communion natin with the Lord. Di ba? Napakahalaga nung daily devotion natin, napakahalaga nung congregational prayer natin, napakahalaga nung patuloy nating pag-submit, nung patuloy nating pag-acknowledge ng power ng Panginoon, ng Holy Spirit, and yung dependence natin sa Kanya. Di ba? Kasi kung hindi kayo nananalangin, it's a sign of arrogance. Lord, kaya ko naman eh. Pag di ko na kaya, I will come back to you. A prayerless life is an arrogant life. Okay? Lord, alam ko na yan. Naturo na yan sa amin. Di ba? That's why you don't read your Bible. Ang galing mo naman. Di ba? If you don't read your Bible, it's as if saying, I know everything, I got things figured out. No. Diba? Ganito po eh, may nakita akong isang illustration, sabi niya, if you think Jesus, I will say, okay, Jesus will come here in 5 minutes, He will talk to us today. Siguro lahat kayo magmamadali, no? Kailangan ng notebook. Lahat ng sasabihin ni Jesus, ibibidyo natin yan. Alam yun, you're so eager to hear from Jesus, not realizing that the Word of God is actually the Holy Spirit talking to you, the God that you want to hear talking in front. It's the same God. Siya din yun. But we don't see the same enthusiasm. Diba? Pag nakarinig tayo ng mga great preachers, si ganito, pupunta sa Bahrain. Sold out yan. Pero you don't read your Bibles with the Holy Spirit talking to you. We're looking for people to talk in front of us when our Bibles are sitting at home waiting for you to talk to God. Diba po? Tapos magtataka ka, Pastor, but nag-witness ako, ginawa ko na lahat. Pero hindi effective. Go back to your Bible. Go back to your room, kneel down before God, and ask for the power of the Holy Spirit again to work in you. Nandun po ang power. Ang witnessing natin, ang power nun, nasa Holy Spirit. Okay? So yun po yung ating pag-uusapan. It's about power, the power of the Holy Spirit. The next one is, so the truth is, our effectiveness in witnessing lies in the power of the Holy Spirit that is in us. So our application, let us continue to nurture our personal and congregational relationship with the Holy Spirit. So patuloy nating pag-alabin ang pagmamahal natin sa banal na Espiritu. Dapat we long for times when we will be praying, we long for times when we'll be worshiping God, we long for the times where we will be reading our Bibles. Okay? Kasi po, dito natin makinig tayo, patuloy tayo makipag-commune, patuloy nating palawigin yung sensitivity natin sa Holy Spirit. For there is power in that communion. There is power in that intimacy with the Holy Spirit. Okay? Next. Sabi niya po, my witnesses. Oh, pati yung pagkasabi ko nung may, naulitin. Okay. My witnesses. Ano po daw yun? Sabi nito, it implies direct relationship to Jesus. Sabi niya, you will be my, akin, magiging witnesses ko kayo. Yung pag-ano ko, parang yung bagong Bible, eh, no? Taglish. Okay. Magiging witnesses ko kayo. Sabi doon. So, ibig sabihin daw po, merong direct relationship with Jesus. Okay? So dapat daw po, if you want to become a witness of God, first thing, you have to have a personal, direct relationship with Him. That's essential. So ito po, it's between you and the Lord. Si Lord, si Jesus, ang nire-represent po. And sabi dito, telling people about Jesus everywhere. Telling people about Jesus everywhere. Okay? Telling people about Jesus everywhere. Okay? Malagay yung telling tsaka everywhere eh. We tell both in words and action. Okay? We have to remember that. We tell people about Jesus with our words. Okay? Pareho yun. We share the gospel. God's law and God's son. We use that. Okay? We use the bridge illustration. So, yeah, that's telling with our words. But with our actions also, we tell about who Jesus is. And sabi dito, you tell about Jesus everywhere. Everywhere. Kahit saan ka magpunta, you tell about Jesus. You speak about Jesus. Okay? So, meron akong challenge na ginawa before pa, matagal na to eh, na sinusubukan ko siya every time. Yung kapag po, I'm stuck with 1 hour sa isang lugar, I pray, Lord, give me the chance to talk about you today to someone here. Kaya madalas po sa airport, nagagawa ko yun. Kasi medyo matagal yung waiting, no? So sa airport, nakakapag-share ako. Sometimes with words, sometimes with action. Okay, depende po kung ano po yung... So let's make it a challenge. Don't allow yourself to spend 1 hour with someone sitting next to you and not talking about Jesus. Dapat masabi mo yun. Either in your words or in your action. Okay, that's a challenge na pwede po natin gawin para makasanayan natin yung pag-speak about Jesus. Pero 3 years na yung kasama mo sa work, di nga niya alam yung si Christ eh. Diba? 3 years ka na doon, 5 years na yung iba. Pero nagulat sila nung nakita kayo dito. Nandito ka din pala. Small world. Nice, no? Alam niyo po yun, na parang, di ba, we speak about Jesus everywhere. Kasi ang sabi po, di ba, go and make disciples. Yung go doon, sa iba pong salin, sabi doon, habang ikaw ay nabubuhay, as you go on living your life, make disciples. Ibig sabihin, hindi kailangang isipin nyo na, go, I have to go out my way. Sometimes you do, but most of the time, while you are living your life, you speak about Jesus. That is your call. Okay? So, my witnesses. Sabi po dito, by this, everyone, may dalawang bagay po akong nakita sa scripture that can help us become effective in witnessing as a church. Okay, ito po yung una. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. Okay, alam na natin ito, madaming beses itong na-discuss dito. Love people, love God, share with them, be open with them, be generous. Pero tingnan po natin sa early church, ano po yung ginawa nila? Sa Acts 2:42-47, they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship, to the breaking of bread and to prayer. Everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs performed by the apostles. All the believers were together and had everything in common. They sold property and possessions to give to anyone who had need. Every day, they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes and ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. Ano po? Yung loving pala, ibig sabihin, it's being thankful. Despite the persecution, we are grateful. Lord, persecuted kami sa Bohol. Praise God! It's an opportunity to see the working of the Holy Spirit. Ano po yun? Yung we are grateful because God Himself is more than enough for us. So ano man yung meron tayong kalalagayan ngayon, mapagpasalamat tayo. LG na naman. Pastor, pwedeng next week na lang yung LG. Off muna tayo today. Skip muna. Di ba? Is that being grateful? Is that being grateful that you are being led to Christ and that you are being nurtured and that you are being discipled? Gratefulness ba yun? Di ba? We have to give that sign of gratitude. The Lord, I want this! And I want this badly! Ano po yun? That is what you are grateful for. Yung umaapaw na pagpapala ng Panginoon sa pamamagitan ng kanyang salita at sa pamamagitan ng pagmamahal ng iyong mga kasama. Yun po, sabi dito, they are generous with one another. Okay? Dapat daw po, ang loving one another is being generous of one another. We be generous. Ano ginawa? Binyenta nila lahat. Anong ari-arian nila para ibigay sa mga nangangailangan. Oras mo, hindi mo mabigay. Tawag na naman tong discipler ko. 5 minutes. Sagutin kita pag di ka tumigil. Ano po yun? Na sometimes, no, we become so selfish. Yeah, oh, so madamot. We become so selfish of, ano, kakabasa ko to talaga ng ano eh. Nagiging selfish tayo masyado with our own resources para bang mauubusan ka. If you think mauubusan ka, then you're not grateful. Kapag nagsimula ka ng mag-isip na may mauubos sa'yo, nagsisimula ka ng hindi maging mapagpasalamat. Okay? So yun po, no? They are evident with gratefulness and with generosity. And nakita po natin doon, and the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. Ito po, we are talking here of the time when the early church is persecuted. Okay, pinapersecute pa sila nito. Hindi may parking, hindi may transport, hindi may pagkain after the service. They are persecuted at this time. But because of their generosity and their love for one another, the Lord added to their number. Daily. Okay? Daily. So yun po, we need to love one another with gratefulness and generosity. Ito po yung pangalawa. Sabi po sa John 17:20-21, si Jesus po ito, sabi niya, my prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one. Father, just as you are in me and I am in you, may they also be in us so that the world may believe that you have sent me. Ano po ibig sabihin? Actually, I was led to this verse kasi po, naalala ko dun sa Pentecost, sabi dun, sabi, they are waiting in a room. Tama po. Sa ibang translation, sabi doon, they are in one accord, waiting. So, they are in one accord. Ibig sabi, sabi ko, okay, why they are in one accord? What is the point of being in one accord? Anong sense nun na that they are in one accord? I think that's New King James Version nung verse na yun sa Acts chapter 2. Na ang sabi doon, they are in one accord. Ano pong ibig sabihin? Napakahalaga po that we are one. That we are united. The church has to be united. Dapat po magkakasangga tayo, magkakakampi po tayo. Dapat po yun ang tingin natin sa isa't isa. We are co-heirs in Christ. At the same time, we are partnering in the kingdom. Us as a local church and as part of the universal body of Christ. Kakampi natin sila. Okay? Kakampi natin sila. Ayan po. So ano po ito? Thank you, bro. So magda-dragon boat po tayo today. Dito po ito hinahawakan. Tama, di ba? Ha? One fist away. Sorry. Okay. Ito po yung dragon boat. Okay? Sa dragon boat po, paano po sila mananalo? Kailangan sabay-sabay. Ano pa? Ano pa? They should follow the beater. Oo, dapat pina-follow nila yung instructions nun. Ano pa? Dapat malakas. Correct. In short, they should be united, one in purpose, and that is to win the race. Iisa yung direction natin. Dapat mananalo tayo, dyan tayo pupunta. Straight tayo, dyan tayo lahat. Okay? You don't go your own way. Kasi ganyan siya ng ganyan, ikaw ganyan ka ng ganyan. Hindi ka nakakatulong, kapatid. Diba? Papunta sila sa kanan, papunta ka sa kaliwa. Okay? There should be one direction. And every one of us knows where we are going. Kasi kung sa iba ka papunta, naliligaw ka and you're causing delay. Okay? And pangalawa, kailangan daw yung sagwan pare-pareho ang lalim. Okay? Kasi pag dinidip mo lang na ganyan, ang tawag sa'yo, nakikiangkas. Diba? Huwag kang makiangkas, kapatid! Lumabang ka! Lumabang ka! Okay? Huwag angkas, huwag yung tampi. Sana ginanyan mo na lang yung kamay mo. Okay? Tapos nag-selfie ka. Habang ang iba ay pagod na pagod sa pagsagwan, ikaw nakikiselfie. Okay? That's not what unity is about. Being on the boat doesn't mean you are with us. Sometimes you're causing us weight. Ihagis ka na lang sa dagat. Okay? So hindi pwedeng makisaw-saw lang. Okay? It's an all or nothing choice. It's an all or nothing commission. Lahat-lahat. Okay? Kasi pag nagsasaw-saw ka lang, ang cute mo eh. Di ba? Pero actually, yung kakitan mo, one day, nakakainis na yan. Okay? You will cause people to stumble. Okay? So when you are united, when the church is united, we are going in one direction with all our efforts, the same time, realizing, okay, that I'm doing this because I am part of a team. I am united with my church. I am united with my life group. And lastly, I am hearing the beating of my God's heart. Ito po ang puso ng Panginoon, to seek and save the lost. Dapat yun yung naririnig mo, yung pagtibok ng puso ng Panginoon mo. Dapat yun ang sinusundan mo. Huwag yung mga telenovela. May mga tugtugan din doon. Pero dapat yung, thank you bro, dapat ang pinapakinggan mo ay yung tunog ng tibok ng puso ng Panginoon mo. Doon tayo pupunta. So meron daw pong mga kalaban ang unity of the church. Sabi po dito, ayan, maganda to. Sabi sa John 21:21-22, when Peter saw him, he said to Jesus, he saw the apostle who's beloved, Lord, what about this man? Jesus said to him, if it is my will that he remain until I come, what is that to you? You follow me. Kasi po, sinabi ni Jesus, mamamatay ka ng ganito, you will die. You will suffer for me, mamamatay ka, a painful death, shameful death for me. Sabi ni Peter, okay. Eh bakit siya? Sabi ng Panginoon, eh anong pakialam mo? Di ba? What is that to you? Anong pakialam mo? Kung gusto ko siyang mabuhay hanggang sa pagbabalik ko, hindi mo problema yon. Anong gagawin mo? You follow me. Pwede daw po nating basahin to sa tatlong pamamaraan. Una, Yung sinabi ko na yon, comparing. Lord, ako hirap na hirap, siya hindi. What is that to you? You go, you carry on with what you're doing. If you're doing well, ipagpatuloy mo. Okay? Because comparing can cause division. Next, complaining. Ito, isa pa. Bakit ako maghihirap, siya hindi? Bakit sila ganun? Diba? Bakit kailangan mag-LG? Bakit kailangan mag-leaders meeting? Kailangan pang mag-attendance? Kailangan pang... Ang dami. Bakit ang dami? Minsan hindi mo pa nga nagagawa, nagko-complain ka na eh. Diba? Most of the time, ganun eh. We don't try, we start to complain before trying. Kasi kung nasubukan mo talaga siya ng tama, kung nasubukan mo ng tama yung pagdidisipulo, mararanasan mo yung I am with you always. And you will never get enough of it. Pag nasubukan mo ng tama yung pagdidisciple, you will never get enough of knowing Jesus more and more by doing this. Pero nag-complain ka kasi muna bago ka gumawa. So hindi mo masubukan yung pangako ng Panginoon. Okay, and lastly, competing. Okay, may magandang competition, pero may competition din naman na hindi na maganda. Okay, hindi po tayo nagpaparamihan ng life group member. It's not about quantity. It's about quality. But a life group of good quality will naturally reproduce. Imposible na ang punong malusog hindi magbubunga. So yun po yung sinasabi natin, hindi pilitan ng pagdami. Palusugan, hindi patabaan ha. Palusugan ng LG. The healthier the LG, the naturally it will reproduce. Okay? So tingnan po natin, sometimes our LGs do not reproduce. Why? Because it's not healthy. Balikan natin, let's stick to the vine, to the true vine, where all nutrients and sources will come from. Okay? Yun po. And pangatlo, ay truth muna. The most effective witness of the church is its love for one another and unity. Let us make our church a place known for its love for each other. Let us protect the unity among believers. Alam niyo pa, pag sinabing BCF, anong naisip niya? Tinapay, no? Nakuha ko na rin yan sa isang survey. Bread Christian Fellowship. That's good, no? Hindi naman masamang nagpapakain tayo ng tinapay. Pero we should be known more than the bread that we are giving. We should be known because we are loving people. We should be known. Punta ka sa BCF, tatanggapin ka nila dyan. Hindi ka nila huhusgaan dyan. Pumunta ka sa BCF because it's a place of refuge. It's a place of safety. It's a place where you'll experience God's love in all its form. Dapat we are known for that. As a church, BCF should be known with the way we love as the Lord loves us. Yun dapat yung identity natin as a church. And we work towards that. Amen po ba? We will love God more so that we can love others more. Okay? And then we should be protecting the unity of the church. Okay? Huwag kayong mag-entertain ng mga complain, compare, and competition. Nagsisimula lahat yan sa chismis. Diba? Yung chismis talaga very powerful eh. Oo. So, and madalas yan, ano yan eh, nagko-cover yan sa prayer. Pag-pray natin si Pastor ganito kasi ganito siya. Alam mo ba yun? Diba? Alam mo ba? Ito pa. Pag sinabi na sa'yo, alam mo ba? Chismis yun. Hindi ko alam it. I don't want to know. Okay? You pray for them. Lahat tayo binabago ng Panginoon. That's why we belong to a loving church. Why? Because hindi ako perfect. By God's grace, I am being changed from glory to glory day by day. Kayo din. Lahat tayo. Let BCF be known as a church of people being molded by God from glory to glory each day. Walang perfect, pero lahat ay pinaging dapat sa dugo ng Panginoon. That is what BCF is about. Okay? Next. Mabilis po ba? Ayan, next movement. Okay, yung movement, nakuha ko po yun sa, dito sa verse na to. Ayan, Acts 1:8. Sabi doon, in Jerusalem, in all Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. The church should be a movement. Ano po ibig sabihin? Sabi po, ang movement daw po is a tactical or strategic sets of action. Ibig sabihin pala, a church should not stand still. Sabi nga, nung nabasa kong commentary, sabi doon, a church should be a movement, not a monument. Okay? A church should be yung gathering, okay? A church is a gathering, okay, of people and going out again, okay? Yung mga tao na to, lalabas sila ulit. We gather so that we can go out. We gather here, worship God, hear from God, and go out, okay? And spread the word of God. Sabi dito, it aims to have an expanding sphere of influence or territory. The church is a movement dahil meron siyang gustong marating. Okay? It's an expanding sphere of territory. Okay? That's why we should not be contented kung tatlo pa rin kayo sa LG, no, 3 years na kayo, one person a year. Because dapat ang mindset mo, I should have an expanding sphere of influence. Diba? In Christ. Dapat ang goal natin, dumami kami ng dumami. As we grow healthier in Christ, we grow in number also. Okay? Dapat daw po, meron tayong ganong pananaw. Because when the church stops to think about going outside, they start to become an institution rather than a movement. Okay? Ang church po is a movement. Tayo po ay movement. Tayo ay kilusan. Meron tayong isang ipinaglalaban. Meron tayong pinakikibaka. Meron tayong sinusundan na direksyon. And that is to seek and save the lost in Christ. Okay? So paano daw po tayo magiging movement? Sabi dito, in Jerusalem, in all Judea, Samaria. So yun nga pa, pinapakita na hindi ka magsasatisfy sa Jerusalem lang. Kailangan mapunta ka ng Judea. Kailangan mapunta ka ng Samaria. And kailangan mapunta ka to the ends of the earth. Sabi nga po, ang church daw po, ang word ecclesia means a gathering or an assembly of people called out for a specific purpose. It's a gathering of people. Hindi nag-stop dun eh. Okay? Yung ecclesia na ginagamit sa New Testament, hindi siya nag-stop dun sa gathering of people. Kasi if you stop there, this is a meeting. Okay? We are gathering here because we are called out for a specific purpose. Yun yung ecclesia na ginagamit ng New Testament. Nag-gather tayo for a specific purpose. And that is to go out and share God's word. Okay? So dapat alam natin yun. This is the church. We are the church. We gather here because we need to go out. Okay? Yun po ang isang movement. So the truth is, the church is more than a destination or an assembly. It is an assembly with a defined purpose. It is a group of people called out to fulfill Jesus' commission. Okay? Hindi lang tayo nag-meet. Kaya yung LG nyo, hindi lang yun para mag-meet kayo. Your LG has a purpose, and that is to reach the lost for Christ. Kung meeting lang kayo ng meeting, you become a meeting, not a life group. Okay? Because your life group meets to reach the lost. Diba? Kaya po mahalaga na lagi nating naaalala yun sa LG natin. Hindi kami nag-meet para masabing mag-meet lang kami at makapag-send kami ng attendance. We meet because we want to pursue this cause and we want to pursue this purpose. Okay? So ano daw po yung application? Serve your calling and purpose. Intentionally go and make disciples. Intentionally go and make disciples. Pwede nyo na pong picturan. Yan. Inintay nyo yan eh. Okay. Ayan po yung mga LG questions natin. Pero tawagin ko po si Kuya Rammer and I want us to... Ayun po, no? Ang sinasabi lang po natin today, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we shall be His witnesses in a movement of going and making disciples. Ano po, isang reality nito that we have to remember is this. Ang isang reality po na kailangan po nating maalala ay ito. These are God's commands. Okay? Ito po mga bagay na to, this is not an option for you. Hindi siya option na ibinigay para sa'yo. Iniutos to sa'yo. Therefore, kung hindi ka gumagawa ng disipulo, if you don't see yourself as a Christian with a purpose, if you don't see your church as a church with a mission, if you don't see your church as a church on the move, then there is a problem. the problem of disobedience, the problem of a disobeying heart. Ano po? We should be approaching God's word with fear and trembling, yeah? Kasi si Lord to eh. He's the one talking to you. He's the one telling you. He's the one asking you to be an ambassador for Him. It's Jesus Himself with the Holy Spirit asking you, will you speak about me? Will you talk about me? Will you represent me with your friends? Will you be my witness with your colleagues? Or you will just enjoy the company of BCF? Or you will just enjoy the company of these Christian people who love you? That's not your purpose. That's not what you are called for. You are called to be a witness for Christ. You are saved once, hindi ka naman namatay, because of a purpose. And that is to speak about that saving grace that you experience. With all eyes closed, pikit po tayo. I want us to meditate or recall our daily routine. Isipin niyo po yung routine niyo sa bawat umaga. What is the first thing that you do in the morning? What is the first thing that comes into your mind in the morning? Is it about the mission? Is it about knowing Christ more? It is about hearing from God today? Is it about asking the Lord, Lord, what is it that you want me to do today? Lord, ano yung ipinapagawa mo sa akin sa araw na to? Is it about that? Or is it about your work? Is it about your baon? Is it about your family in the Philippines or family here? Is it about your ministry? Is it about something else that you think more important than the mission? This is your calling. This is who you are. A redeemed Christian. A redeemed person that God is calling to be an ambassador. Manalangin po tayo. Panginoon, patawarin mo kami, God, kung sa mga pagkakataon, Lord, na mas pinipili namin, Panginoon, na maging abala sa mga bagay na hindi naman talaga, Panginoon, nakakadagdag sa kingdom mo. Lord, mas pinipili namin, Panginoon, mag-exert ng effort, time, money, on things that are not extending your kingdom. Lord, give us the power of the Holy Spirit today. And as we walk on faith, Panginoon, patuloy na pag-apawin mo kami, Panginoon, sa banal mong Espiritu, so that we will be your witnesses, not just in Bahrain, not just in the Philippines, but to the ends of the earth. Lord, we do this because this is our privilege to be of service to you. It is an honor. This is the least that we can do with the amazing grace that you have given us. Lord, ito lang yung kaya talaga naming gawin. We may sing with all that we have. We may dance with all that we have. We may study the all that we have. But all this should boil down to one thing. This is our mission. I sing because I represent Christ. I dance because I represent Christ. I study because I represent Christ. Nothing of it should stay with me. Nothing of it should be for my purpose alone. It should go out. It should serve its purpose of reaching the nation. Lord, I know one day, inasmuch as you are true and your words are true, one day every knee will bow, every tongue shall confess, every life, Panginoon, will declare that you are God. Lord, isali mo kami. Isali mo kami, Panginoon, sa mission mo of seeking and saving the lost. In Jesus' name, amen. Papuri po sa Panginoon.